Hi, my name is Srinivas. I manage training activities at VLSA Guru Institute. As you are aware, VLSA Guru Institute offers courses in VLSA frontend, VLSA backend domain, embedded systems, and software testing domain. So since we offer various courses, we thought of creating a video which gives a student with the overview of various aspects of the course, which includes information on course registration, which includes information on course planning, course material, and how to get the tool access, fee payment, missed sessions. So we have created this video so that student gets to know all this information before they start on the course. I mean, they should have got the complete course material. They should have got the required tool access. So we didn't want any student to miss out on any of the aspects. So hence we have created this video. So please ensure that you go through this video before you start on the course. So that if you have not got any specific access, let's say you didn't get the tool access, you didn't get the course page access, you didn't get a course material, you can always send us a mail saying that I haven't got this specific access. Okay, so what would be the agenda for this session? Like how the course registration works, course planning, course material and tool access, in which we'll talk about tool access, tool usage video, access to the course page, course checklist, course assignments, labs and session notes, how to use the course material, fee payment guidelines, what if you miss some sessions, that is missed sessions, lab sessions, doubt clarifications, self-assessment, job opportunities, how we help with resume update, interview questions, mock interviews, job support from the institute. So these are the various things that we are going to discuss in this presentation. So the first thing you should have done when you joined a course is you must have completed the course registration. Please ensure that you have filled course registration form. So basically what does that have? It has got information about your degree, BTech or MTech or some other degree, what is your percentage, if you are looking for a job support or if you are looking for higher studies. So we have various aspects in the various entries in that registration form. You need to fill that form. I mean, we are not taking all these details about your percentages and all those things not to filter you. It is only to get the information so that we can find the right opportunities for you. When we, let's say we need to provide you job support. So your resume, registration form helps us with all the information. Let's say you are experienced. So what kind of companies we can support you with? So that is where you need to fill the course registration form. So what else does course registration involve? I mean, filling that form and you need to make the initial part of the fee payment. Next. The most important thing of the course is a course planning. I mean, not from a trainer perspective. I'm talking from a student perspective. So what is that course planning involves? Most important thing is undergoing an evaluation test. Please ensure that you take evaluation test as per the course you're planning to pursue. Now the question comes, how does it help me? I mean, me means student. How does it help a student? Evaluation test based on what course you go for. Let's say you go for VLSA frontend course. And let's say we have 20 students in a batch. There is a very high possibility that all 20 students does not come with the same skill set, same programming knowledge, same digital design concept knowledge, fundamental concepts. So they may come with various backgrounds. Let's say some student who wants to do system Verilog training doesn't know what is Verilog. It doesn't really help him doing the system Verilog course directly. That is where you must undergo an evaluation test where we analyze your performance. So what does typically evaluation test may have for front end training? What does evaluation test will have? It will have a test on digital design concepts. It'll have test on Verilog. It'll be testing on Unix operating system. Then it'll be on basics of scripting languages. Maybe Perl or Perl kind of languages will have. So based on your performance in this evaluation test, if you do well in this test, let's say you are good with digital design, Verilog, Unix, and basics of scripting, then we recommend that you can directly go to the advanced courses like System Verilog course. Let's say in these courses, you are not able to do well in Verilog, but you are good with digital design, Unix, and scripting, then we will say that you can go with the Verilog course. So this evaluation test is only to tell you what is the basics you should be prepared with. So you need to remember that if your basics are not good, even if you do the most advanced courses, you are not going to go reach anywhere. The basics have to be very good. So even if it takes another 1 month time or 2 months time to build the basics properly, you must do it before you go to the advanced courses. So the one thing you need to remember is about how quickly you have completed the VLSA training. It's all about how good are you with the fundamentals. It could be digital design fundamentals, Verilog fundamentals, Unix operating system concepts, scripting concepts. So once you are good with these fundamentals, so learning advanced things becomes quite easy. So please ensure that you undergo an evaluation test. Next, essential basics. So student will be provided inputs on basic courses they need to prepare based on the performance in evaluation test. Once you have undergone evaluation test, a trainer will evaluate your answer sheet. Based on that, we will suggest what kind of basic courses you can go with. Generally, in the institute, basic courses are all offered at a very affordable fee. For example, digital design training is offered at 1000 rupees plus tax. Unix is offered at 600 rupees. Verilog is offered at 5000 rupees. I mean, I don't say that Verilog is affordable or not affordable. That is not what I want to argue. But relatively, if I take the other institutes, Verilog being at 5000 is an affordable fee, as I see. So basics of scripting, again, will be offered at 1000 rupees. So I'm sure if you want to, before you start System Verilog, if you think that you are not really good with basics, you can plan to take some of these courses. Planning the preparation. The next most important thing is planning the preparation. One thing you need to remember is even though you are not good with basics, you don't know anything before when you joined the training. You need to remember that preparation does not get over in 1 week or 2 weeks time, or 1 day or 2 days time, or 1 month time for that matter. It doesn't get over in such short span of time. It takes time, and you need to really accept this fact that it takes time. I mean, you won't be able to finish the preparation in 1 week or 2 weeks or 1 month time. So in that case, what you need to do, let's say you're spending 4.5 months of time for VLSA training. 4.5 months on a VLSA training. It could be front-end training, it could be a back-end training, it could be physical design, DFT, or it could be System Verilog UVM training. You need to basically plan your preparation. So you need to say within first, you divide the 4.5 months into 9 blocks. 9 blocks is what? Each of half a month. So you need to say within first half, that is 0.5 month. You need to say that I will be prepared with the, you prepare one spreadsheet. What do? You create a spreadsheet. Something like first block. I would be familiar with the tool. I will learn how to use tool. Gain expertise in the required fundamentals. Next, learn the basics of the course. I mean, again, start with the learn how to use tool. Start implementing basic examples. Then start reading the required documents. So this is what you need to plan for first block. What is mean by first block here? The first half month. we are talking about around 4 months of training. In that 4 months of training, we are talking about the first half month of training. Then again, you write down like this in second half month, what you are going to. You are going to implement, learn the complete one topic. Let's say if I'm doing system Verilog, complete object oriented programming. Complete the assignment number 1 and 2. Then practice the, revise the notes and make my own notes, make the own notes also. I mean, that institute trainer provides his notes, and on top of that, you need to make a notes for everything, all the courses. You need to create your own notes. How does the notes help? It ensures that when you are going for an interview, it helps you quickly revise the concepts. Third block, I will call it as, right? Like this, you come up with the plan. Then you talk to the trainer. This is the plan. I want to complete my course, because it is your future, your future you are working on. I mean, trainer or institute will only work till one stage. I mean, don't expect that institute will give you this kind of plan where you do this. It is you who should have motivation to do this. Then you go to the trainer and say that this is the plan I have come up with. That do you think, will I be able to do this? So then trainer will give you the inputs. Then what will you do in the third block? Like complete assignment number 3 to 7. Why so many assignments? Because during this 1 month, you would have got enough exposure to the subject that you will be able to do more number of assignments. Then learn advanced concepts. Like this, come up with the fourth block, what you are going to do. So probably at the end of sixth block, what you should be doing is start preparing the resume, prepare the resume. The what is sixth block? It would be third month. Basically, you would have almost reached the third month. So during that time, you should have started preparing the resume. Then start collecting interview questions. Start going through the interview questions. Analyze my preparation. Start attending. So then seventh block, what do you do? Learn other essential concepts. I mean, you have completed majority of the important things like system Verilog, UVM Verilog. Then you learn the other aspects like scripting, Unix, these kind of things. Then start attending mock interviews. Like this, you need to come up with a plan. And please do not expect that trainer will give you this plan. You need to come up with a plan. You should go through the course, what all things I'm going to do, what I'm going to do in the first block, second block, third block. So finally, what will be the ninth block? That is where you start attending the evaluation test. VLSI Guru monthly evaluation test. Completed all course assignments. Then have gone through all interview questions. Then attending, having group discussions with other students. This is how you come up with the plan. Then you talk to the trainer. You tell him, this is the plan I'm having for all the 8 months, 4 months, or 3 months, or 2 months, whatever is your training duration. If you don't go by this planning, you're not going to complete your preparation even in a year. So we have seen students who have been preparing since 2 years, and still their preparation is not complete. Whereas you go with a proper planning like this, where you say, what will you learn in the first quarter, first block of first half of month, second half of month, third half, fourth half, like that you keep planning, you will be definitely able to complete your preparation in the required as per the schedule. And Again, don't be over ambitious. I mean, don't think that you will be able to complete all your assignments in 1 month or 2 months time. It takes time. So you need to go as per that only. Okay, don't stress yourself too much. Next. I hope you understood how do you plan your preparation. Next is hands-on practice. The only one thing you need to remember is read less, understand more, practice maximum. Most of the learning happens when you practice things by yourself. Let's say you learn, you benefit 30%. I mean, you learn the things 30, I mean, you learn 30% by attending sessions. Most of the learning happens when you practice by yourself. Do not read too many documents. Keep some essential documents and read from those documents. Try to understand as much as possible from that documents only. And don't think that if I read 10 websites, I'll get more information. No. Try to have some very small number of documents and read them with lot of concentration and learn as much as possible. And most importantly, practice as maximum. You should be doing maximum amount of practice. So you should, that is why I said in this planning, you should have basically started using the tool from the first half month itself. Let's say you miss this schedule, your preparation is going to slip. I mean, let's say you learn this tool in the fourth block. Here, let's say you move this block to here. Automatically, your preparation is going to go to seventh month. So you need to ensure that you have this kind of proper planning and you are preparing as per this plan. So if you are preparing without this kind of plan, then you are never going to get a job. Let me be very clear. You are preparing without this kind of planning. You are definitely not going to get a job in within 1 to 1.5 years. But if you prepare with this plan, by 4.5 months, your preparation is complete. Probably by around 6th or 7th month, you'll have a job. That is what this I'm not telling based on my preparation or anything. This is based on my experience with students. We have seen close to 1,000 students preparing at various stages, some people coming from various backgrounds. So we have seen them. So based on that, we are telling that if you prepare as per this plan, you will be able to get a job in within 6 to 7 months, maybe within 4 months itself. What does it mean? You need to do more practice rather than reading. Start writing examples. I'm sure trainer helps you understand how to write the examples. So try to do the same thing. Whatever trainer is doing, do the same thing from your side also. Once you gain perfection in that, if you are able to replicate what trainer is doing, then start doing your own examples. Dedicate few hours of every week for hands-on practice. What is meant by hands-on practice? Practicing on the tool. Reading less. Don't read too many. I mean, every full day, don't read. Read for 3-4 hours. Practice for 2-3 hours. And as you go to the end of the course, you should be reading less and you should be practicing more. That is the indication of a very good preparation. Preparation schedule. You come up with a schedule for your preparation. 2 hours of self-preparation time for every 1 hour of training session. Let us say you are attending system Verilog training. So 8 hours of training you undergo per week. You should be spending minimum 16 hours of self-preparation. If you are missing anything, if you are doing anything less than that, that means you are not, your preparation may not be up to the mark. So please ensure that you are able to take out 16 hours in a week. Like 3 hours I'll sit in Monday, 2 hours on Tuesday, 2 hours on Wednesday. Then you count, does it make up 16 hours? So then you prepare. Let's say you are spending anything less than that, then your preparation won't be up to the mark. The next thing, job search. Do not try for job with no preparation. What do you do? I mean, by doing that, what do? You lose opportunities. We don't have infinite number of companies in VLS domain. For that matter, there is nowhere. There are only limited companies, like maybe 100 companies or 150 companies, for example. If you think that I'll apply for 100 companies, one of them I'll at least get through without any preparation, it is not going to happen. You need to ensure that you prepare, complete your preparation, like we discussed in this schedule. by third month, I mean sixth block, I'm going to finish my preparation. Then you can start creating your resume. Then you can start uploading. Then you can start applying for interviews. Then we have also created one page called as Student Guidelines. You go through this page, vlsaguru.com Student Guidelines. It talks about every aspect of your course, like how to prepare, like what if you are not happy with the course, you want to discontinue the course, what is the course repayment policy, everything. Let's just quickly go over that. Here you can find that Student Guidelines. So it talks about how to know what is your course prerequisites. It talks about course registration, how course registration work, what kind of placement support you get from institute, how should you prepare effectively before attending session, what you should do while attending session, what if you miss some sessions, what is a fee payment and refund policy, and how to get the lab sessions, how frequently they are organized, course checklist, assignment completion guidelines, job preparation, and other important points. So please ensure that you go through that page. If you still have further queries, please come back to us. Next. Course material and tool access. When you register for the course, that is meant by registration means either you do the online fee transfer or you make the fee payment in cash. You get access to the required tools. You should also be getting access to the tool user guide. You should also be getting access to the VPN access. Through VPN, you will get the tool access and how to use the tool. We have videos for every tool usage. Let's say you're using Synopsys ICC. We'll have one video, half an hour, 1 hour video, which will explain how to invoke the tool, how to use different options in the tool. Same way, if you are registered for System Verilog course, we have a video which explains how to use QuestaSim, how to create a project, how to compile, elaborate, different stages. That video also should be requesting access. You should get access to the course page. Where is the course page present? Go to this. There are various courses here. If I go to my courses, I mean, in my case, I'm an admin. So I'll have access to all the courses for that matter. Because being admin, I'll have access to all the courses. Let's say I will go with some other login which I have created other than admin. If I go to that, I'll just show you. You have to go to this page, vlsaguru.com wp-admin, which is the page you have to go to. You have to go to course page. www.vlsiguru.com wp-admin. You go to this page, it will automatically prompt you to enter the login details and password. In that case, what you should do is go to your Gmail. In the Gmail, search for WordPress. Search for WordPress. You'll automatically, like in my case, I would have got some new user registration. When I registered user, I get this mail. Whereas you would get your username and the password. From that, you get the username and password. It will also tell you the login page. Then you go to that login page. Let's say I go to one page called as this one. So here, what do I get? Basically, I am logging into my account in the website, vlsaguru.com website. So in that, I will get access to all the courses that I have been registered to. In this case, I am registered to Perl Online Training, PCL Training, PCI Technology Training, SOC Design Verification Training. Let us say you are registered to System Verilog for Functional Verification course. So you will see only this course. You won't see other courses. In my case, because I have added all courses to my account, VLSAguru9 account. In this case, what do? You click this continue learning page. You click this. You go to this page. So what does this page basically has? It has got course assignments related to language constructs, Ethernet loopback design, AXA protocol, AXA VAP, industry standard project. So whatever you see here, these are all assignments. this is interview questions. I mean, if you go to this, you'll get the interview questions. Like in the after that, what you get is session notes. Every session, like I'm writing a note here. You see, I'm writing a note here. The same way, we write a note every session. Whatever session we do, we write a notes. That notes is uploaded to this page. So, if, for example, we are doing a current batch May 2017. If you go to this, you will get the notes from all the sessions that happened in May 2007 SV batch. Okay, so we have uploaded almost 8 pages. So if you go to this, let's say whatever session happened on that specific one specific date. Oh, somehow it is not uploaded in this. Let's see if I go to this page. So whatever we did on 27th May, so we'll get access to that specific notes here. Like this, if you go to the course assignments, you'll find all the assignments. So you click, otherwise click units. If you want to go back to the original page, you click units, you'll get various units. So assignments are part of the units. If I go to SV language constructs, I'll get all the assignments in SV language constructs. So similarly, the pages have been maintained for all the courses, Verilog, UVM, System Verilog, Physical Design, DFT, STA. For every course, there will be a page. So here you will get access to the required things. For example, here we already know that you should have gone through these videos. We have told that you should have gone through these videos. So that is where we have mentioned request for access by sending mail to contact@vlsfv.com. Here, what do you have? Checklist. Like, what is the essential list of things we should have covered in this course? Similarly, various assignments. If you go to this, you'll get the assignments in this page. So like that, almost 16 assignments are there in this. Like AXI, there are assignments. Ethernet loopback design, there are assignments. So this is one of the assignments. So this is what you get in the course page. You get access to the notes. You get access to the interview questions. You get access to the assignments. So please ensure that you have got access to the course page. So I told you how to get the login details. You go to the mail account and search for WordPress. You'll automatically get that mail. Because in most of the cases, it will go to a spam folder. It doesn't come to the inbox. I've already showed you where to find the course checklist. Course checklist is part of the course page. Course assignment is also part of the course page. The next thing, important thing about course assignments is the submission guidelines. Generally, we follow completing assignments is a very important aspect of the course. So at every, let's say the course is a 10 weeks course. Course is 10 weeks or 10 or let's say System Verilog course may extend to 12 weeks, for example, because in between we'll do the labs, 12 weeks course. So we will have, we'll tell you some guidelines, like within third week, you must complete assignment one. If you don't do that, you won't be eligible for the attending sessions in the fourth week. Then you may say, I have paid the fee. Why am I not allowed to attend the complete course? Because we believe that if you don't complete the assignment, you won't really follow the next set of sessions. So in that case, what is the option you have? You have to repeat the course. If you don't complete assignment by third week, you'll have to repeat the course. So please, you need to maintain. I mean, we'll give you this kind of guidelines. Probably by end of fourth week, you should have completed assignment number 2 and 3. Like that, for every week, we'll have plan. Fifth week, you should have completed 4th and 5th assignment. Like that, I mean, you may say, why are you giving 3 weeks for assignment one? Why are you giving so much less time for other assignment? Assignment one, in case of System Verilog, is very tough. I mean, it takes a lot of time. Once you complete that, rest of the assignment takes only 1/10 of that time, probably 1/5 of that time. Because assignment one covers object-oriented programming, it will be long. So same may apply for other courses. Let's say you're doing physical design course or you're doing DFT course. So the trainer will tell you what is the schedule for your completion, when you should have completed assignment. If you don't follow that schedule, you will be dropped from the course. Basically, drop means you will be asked to continue in the next batch. So that is importance. That is the importance of submitting your assignment. So where do you submit your assignments? You need to send whatever assignments you work. Let's say you have to create folders. Question one. In that you do that. You develop the code. Question two. Develop the question two specific code. You do all this in a complete folder. Assignment number one is the complete folder. So then keep the folder. Send it to submit@vlsiguru.com. Then we'll get the folder. Folder or directory, whatever. We'll get the folder and then we'll evaluate and tell you how is your preparation. So then how do we track this assignment completion? We have one spreadsheet where all the names will be listed with the assignments as the column elements. So we'll keep yes or no to track whether a student is completing an assignment or not. Why this assignment is so important? I mean, why am I putting so much stress in these assignments? This is the only way I know whether your preparation is good or not. You may be attending all the sessions of the course, but what is the guarantee that you are learning out of it? So how do I come to know? It is the only assignments how I come to know. Even if you don't attend any of the sessions, if you complete all assignments properly, you are better, you are doing better than any other student. So that is the importance of assignments. And at one point, you need to remember that you are doing assignments not for the trainer's sake, you are doing for your purpose. It is you who benefit out of doing the assignments. Next thing, labs and session notes. Labs sent over mail at the end of every session. So generally, when we do the course, we develop some codes, we develop some scripts, different aspects. So we'll be sending that labs at end of every session to the complete mailing list. Session notes updated to the course page. Then we'll also provide you one document on how to use course material. In many cases, it may so happen that you may get a lot of material. You may get many documents, you may get some labs, you may get some documents to read, you may get some user guides, you may get some interview questions. So that you course how to use course material, there will be document which will tell you how to start going through the course material, what documents you should read first. That kind of guidelines you will get. Next, fee payment. Generally, you can pay, I mean, you can pay the fee in one installment itself, I mean, in one shot itself. Otherwise, you always have flexibility to pay the fee in two installments. This is how the installment should work. First half, payable after attending the demo session. So it is compulsory that you should have paid the fee very next day after attending the demo session. Let's say the demo session is on 3rd June. So 3rd June demo session should give you a complete overview of the course, trainer, how trainer is offering the course, various aspects of the course you should get. On 4th June, you must register for the course. By any chance, if you try to attend for the course, it could be a humiliating experience, and we generally don't want such things to happen in the class where you are trying to deceive us and you are trying to join the course without paying the fee. You are trying to default the fee. You should understand that we have seen many of your students. I mean, probably you will be the 1,000th student. So do not try to deceive a trainer or the institute admins, right? Probably it could be at one point if you try to default the fee, it could be a humiliating experience for us, for you. So we recommend, I mean, we suggest don't do that. Please pay the fee as per the schedule. First half should be paid after attending the demo session. Second half should be payable within 1 month after course registration or before half the course duration, whichever is the lowest, whichever is the earliest, I would say. Yeah. Let us say you are registering for System Verilog course. System Verilog course will typically go for 2.5 months. Let's say you pay the first installment on 4th of June. The next installment must be paid on 3rd of July, on or before 3rd of July. I mean, we don't generally want to kind of remind student that you need to pay the second installment. These are the guidelines. You pay first on, let's say, 4th July, 4th of June, next must be paid on or before 3rd of June, 3rd of July. If it is a Verilog course, let's say it goes only for 5 weeks, then we don't want to wait for 1 month. By then we would have completed the course, and there's a less chance, there's a chance that student may default remaining part. Why am I stressing so much on default? We did had few cases where we were flexible, we were liberal in the student paying the fee. Some student tries to take the misadvantage of that. That is where we have this kind of guidelines where you must pay as per this. So in case of Verilog course, where the course duration is 5 weeks, you should pay the fee exactly after 2 weeks completion. Remaining second half of the fee. Next. Generally we understand that most of the courses are long-term courses, like the 2.5 months courses, 4.5 months courses. So there's always a chance that you have some personal commitment and you don't attend a session. So in that case, you talk to the trainer and ensure that he backs up the whatever sessions you have missed. In all the cases, you will get access to the recorded videos for the missed sessions. So you talk to the institute admin on how to get access to the recorded videos. Lab sessions. Of course, it depends upon the course, but as a general guideline, if you are attending Verilog, SV and UVM, what do you mean by lab sessions? These are the dedicated sessions where you bring your laptop and you start working on the assignments or dedicated lab queries, labs prepared for that session with the trainer guidance. There will be a mentor or a trainer who will be guiding you with all those questions. The reason we have to do this lab session is, ideally, our assumption is that you go home and practice the assignments and you work on assignments, you do the labs. But in some cases, we see that student generally doesn't do at home. We have to ensure that we make it a mandatory to make sure that the student comes to the institute, brings their laptop and start working on the labs. So if it is Verilog, System Verilog and UVM courses, one full day lab session once every 3 weeks. At least at minimum, one full day lab session must be happening every 3 weeks. If it is not happening, then you must bring it to the trainer notice that we didn't had a lab session in last 3 weeks or last 4 weeks. Then trainer will ensure that there is a lab session on that specific day. Let's say you are attending a DFT course. One full day lab session once every 2 weeks or 3 weeks. Again, trainer will define how frequently lab session should be done. It could be the same case with physical design. So I can't really say exactly should it be 3 weeks or 4 weeks. It is the trainer who has planned how frequently lab session should be done. Please understand here, lab session is the most important session because that is where most of your doubts gets clarified. That is where you learn maximum out of the course. And as a general policy, please ensure that every session you bring your laptop, because at the end of every session, we generally ask student to work on some basic labs related to the topic. So for every session, please bring your laptop. So it's a guideline. So you don't need to just bring laptop only for dedicated lab sessions. Every session you need to get your laptop. Doubt clarification. Let us say you have some doubts in Verilog, System Verilog. You can go to this page, vlsguru.com/blog/sv. There you can post your queries. For UVM, /blog/UVM. For physical design, blog physical design. For DFT, blog DFT. Like that, we have many other courses. For every course, we have such blog pages. You can go to these pages and post your query. So what is the benefit of posting these queries in this page? It is like a common database everyone can access. Every student from previous batch, the current batch, even the future batches will have access to your questions. Let us say we are creating one WhatsApp group and discussing that. What is the problem with that? Whatever that has been discussed, that information, knowledge will not be shared to the future batches. Whereas once we have these kind of blog pages where you post your queries, it will be benefiting everyone. Not only your batch, previous batches, it will benefit previous batches, your batch, next batches also. I know it is an effort going to a page and writing your question there, but when we do as a group, it benefits everyone. So please ensure that you post your queries on this. Try to avoid sending your questions on mail, because that is the least productive way of helping someone. Because when I reply back to your mail, I'm only helping you, not anyone else. Whereas if you post your question on these pages, this will be addressed by the trainer. So it ensures that everyone else in the course benefits out of it. Like that, when 300 people post their questions in that page, all 300 people will benefit out of it. Right? So please ensure that you post your doubts in these pages only. Do not post it, send it to the mail. So the chances of you getting a response or mail will be less, because we are encouraging people to post the queries on these pages only. Self-assessment. After all doing this, why are you doing this whole preparation? You're not doing because your father said or someone said to do the course. You want to learn the things and you want to find, basically you want to empower yourself and you want to make yourself suitable for the job. You are not doing completing assignments just because you want to make me happy, make the trainer happy. It is because you learn things by doing the assignments. You start questioning yourself. You start questioning your preparation. So that is where it is important to keep assessing yourself, keep assessing your preparation. So you need to remember here one fact that people come with various backgrounds. So nobody is completely prepared when they started the training. So let's say you are not following the things in session. Don't be discouraged. There were many cases where we had seen such students where they didn't knew anything about Verilog. They didn't knew anything in digital design. Still, they were able to get the job in 5 to 6 months. It is quite possible. Just that you need this kind of planned preparation where you come up with this kind of schedule and prepare according to the schedule. So I'm sure most of the times you will need help from the trainer. When you are putting your dedication, trainer will always be there to help you with all these things. Only thing we expect from a student is he motivated enough? Is he willing to put hard work? So once you are able to do that, trainer is also will go one step further and help you. Let's say you are not motivated for every small thing. You don't do any homework and you go to the trainer, explain me, do this. Then trainer won't help you. You do your homework. You try to understand things from your side. If you don't get it, then you come to the trainer. Let's say you are preparing this kind of planning. Don't go to the trainer and tell him that give me this plan. You do your homework. You come up with this kind of sheet. Then you go to the trainer and say that this is the kind of preparation I want to do. Then trainer will tell you, is this the right preparation? I mean, is it really possible? Then he will give you his inputs. So please. So where does it all come down to? Assessing yourself. At every stage, you keep assessing yourself. Am I completing the assignments? How am I doing in the evaluation tests that are conducted every month? Every month, VLSA Guru Institute conducts evaluation tests in front-end, DFT, physical design, and various other aspects of the courses. So using that, we evaluate the student's preparation. You don't need to really wait till evaluation test, because evaluation test happens only once in a month. You need to assess your preparation once every week. Am I doing well? Where am I missing? Am I doing enough practice? Am I able to clarify my doubts? Am I preparing the notes so that it helps me in the interviews? You need to keep assessing yourself. You need to be motivated at every stage of your preparation. You should not be discouraged, demotivated, because there are many students who come even probably at a much worse preparation level than you. With the right preparation and right planning, every one of you can get a job. Okay. So please ensure that you assess yourself. Again, I'm repeating, you are not assessing yourself to make a trainer happy, to make your parents happy. You're assessing yourself because you need to empower yourself. That comes only by keep assessing your preparation at various stages. You need to question, where am I missing? Am I reading the documents? Am I having right set of documents? Am I using the tool properly? Am I completing assignments? Like that, you keep assessing. Next, job opportunities. The first thing, most important thing, is resume update. So whenever you get the course material will have a Word document which will have the required project updates in the resume. So that document will tell you how to update the resume. In many of the cases, you go to the trainer. Tell him, I need help in updating my resume. Please help me. So definitely he'll conduct one dedicated session to the complete batch where he will tell you how your resume should look like, how to put your skill set, how to present your education, how to present your projects, how to present your extracurricular activities, everything. he's going to give you a dedicated session where they will talk about how to prepare your resume. Do not blindly copy the Word document and paste it in a resume. That is not good. Why resume? Resume is a very important aspect of your job search, because when the resume goes to a trainer, it is the only resume that the employer sees, not to the trainer, employer. It is the only document that employer sees. He doesn't see any other document other than resume. So if your resume is prepared without any, with complete negligency, with randomly you just copy pasted, then you automatically your resume doesn't get shortlisted. Then you start questioning, institute is not helping. So you need to do your homework, you go to the trainer, take their help, and do not start looking for job from the first day of training. Please ensure that your preparation is good, your completed assignments, you're completed, you're doing well in the evaluation test. Then you do it. Then interview questions. When you're looking for jobs, you need support with the interviews. So interview questions are uploaded to the course page. Every course page has interview questions uploaded. So please prepare as per that. Mock interviews. Once your preparation is complete, we'll help you with the mock interviews based on your performance in the assignments and evaluation tests. So we'll help you with at least 10 to 15 mock interviews so that you can assess your preparation. When you attend mock interviews, you come to know whether my preparation is up to the mark. Because let's say you are preparing by yourself, you may be thinking that my preparation is complete. Only when you attend mock interviews, you come to know whether my preparation is up to the mark or not. Next item is job support from the institute. Institute, of course, offers job support for everyone who registered for the course, but they need to meet following criteria. They must have completed 50% of the assignments, and they should be regularly attending the evaluation tests. What this ensures is, this gives us a confidence that student has done the required homework. We can easily take your resume to our company, to other colleagues who are working in various companies, and tell him that please help him get a job. If you don't do this homework, I mean, let's say you haven't done any assignment. For me, you haven't taken a course itself. Let me tell you again. Let's say you haven't submitted any assignments. No assignment submission. That means automatically no course. I mean, course itself is not registered. Course itself is not taken. That means no job support. So for me, the only important thing for me, I don't even, I mean, none of the trainers worry whether you come to the course or not also. It is essential that you come to the course to learn the things, and based on that only you can do assignments. But for me, only criteria is how well you are doing with the assignments, how well you are doing the evaluation test. If you do well in the assignments, let's say you complete 100% of the assignments and you do well in one evaluation test, I will give you the job, whatever is your domain. It could be physical design, it could be DFT, it could be front end. I will give you a guarantee that I'll get you a job, right? So that is the importance of completing the assignments and being serious with the evaluation tests. So I have already mentioned what is evaluation test. Generally, evaluation test is done in the second week of every month. For which all domains we do for Verilog, we do for System Verilog, we do for UVM, we do for physical design, we do for DFT. For every domain, we have evaluation tests. That evaluation test will be evaluated by the trainer, and he will give a grades starting from S, A, B up to F. F means failed. Basically, F means you are not doing anything. You are as good as you haven't taken a course itself. Probably even worse than that. So that is where you need to keep assessing yourself. What grade am I getting? Am I improving in the grade every month? That will tell you if you are doing well or not. So I hope this gives you a overview of various things you should be aware when you take up a course. After having gone through this video, if you still think that there are few questions you have and they have not been addressed in this video, please come back to us. Thank you.